boat, correct?
Yo, 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 what's up, everybody? It's me, Pudding Cup, best friend Firefly.
What's up?
We're gonna be casting you guys some Gold League Highlander action straight out of UGC. What's going on, Firefly?
Not much, how about you, Pud?
It's going great. Got some cool Gold League action. Not really much happening in Platinum these days, so switching to over Gold, some exciting matches. We've got the self-sustaining Mexican Cat Ranch versus the 7-year something or other.
That sounds good enough.
Yeah, they're an upcoming team. Hold on, let me get the actual team name. Sorry, a little unprepared. Expect this match to be going down a little later. I was told 10 Eastern, but it's gonna be happening real soon here. And here we go. The 7 Years Dungeon. So we got Mexican Cat Ranch versus 7 Years Dungeon. Cat Ranch is currently leading the league 5-0. 7 Years right behind them with another, with a couple other 4-1 teams in Gold. So I'm gonna give these teams the go-ahead to start the match. Apparently they have some business to attend to later on. So Firefly, would you care? Actually, no, you don't know these rosters. I've contacted these teams, gotten the rosters. So I'll go down the rosters. If you could message Kessel the go-ahead.
I will do so.
Okay. So over on Mexican Cat Ranch, we're gonna have a few familiar faces for some of you. We've got B-Man, we're playing Soldier. It's an invite, or well, technically an IM scout, but he's real good. And we've got Snailboat on Heavy, another IM scout. Crux on Demo Man, might remember him from looking handsome a while back. Shivago, we play in the Scoutmans. Doppel or Kessel, playing Spy. Got Peyton or Pepe on Medic, normally plays Soldier. Got Billy Bob on Pyro, Tinkelp on Engineer. And the last player would be Attila. I'm not sure what it's taken him to get into the server, but he'll be playing Sniper. Over on the Sunny Side, over on the 7 Year side, we've got Sunny on Soldier. Typhoon, I believe, is on Heavy. Got Waka on Engineer. Only Couches Pull Out on Medic. Bowser 5, who's supposed to be a pretty good sniper, so might want to keep the camera on him. Although Attila's actually pretty insane himself. So Bowser 5, we'd be playing Sniper. Got Doctor, or I think he's tagged up as Magna Defender. He'll be playing Medic. Heartstrings, we playing Demo. Sean Connery on the Pyro. And Fascist, we'll be playing that Scout. So what do you think about in particular B-Man's team, the Mexican Cat Ranch, being in Gold League? I saw them playing against what was the MTS in their pregame. A little interesting seeing a Gold team literally scrimming against the best team in Platinum right now.
Well, there are a lot of good players on Mexican Cat Ranch. I mean, B-Man, Crux, and Snailboat have all been on Heinz teams over the years, and they've obviously done really well. I mean, they won 3 straight seasons of UGC, so... And they've got a pretty good supporting cast, a lot of experienced Highlander players over there. I don't know much about, what was it, 7 Years?
Dungeon.
7 Years Dungeon. I hear Sunny is really good, but he's the only person I recognize on that roster.
Yeah, I think he might be playing open. I'm not really sure. I've definitely seen him in those DM servers. He's definitely pretty solid. But, you know, I was told that this match was going to be good. You know, it's one of the matches that could end up deciding, you know, who takes that Gold division. But I don't know a whole lot about this other team.
Yeah, if I had to make a prediction, I'd probably guess that Mexican Cat Ranch will take this one with a score of something like 5-2 or 5-3.
Yeah,
but
either way, with either
if it stalls out, it may not get to that high of a score. You could see a match in like 3-1 or something like that.
Yeah, especially if I've heard some rumors that Mexican Cat Ranch love to kind of screw around, throw in some goofy strats. So, you know, win or lose, you know, no matter what happens, probably see a good game regardless.
Well,
I'm sure glad to see, you know, Mexican Cat Ranch boys back in Highlander. Even if it is in Gold League. But, we'll see what these 7 years dungeon guys can do. Sort of make a name for themselves. I know Heartstrings in particular is supposed to be a pretty good demo man. I've seen Bowser 5 around. He's supposed to be a pretty insane sniper. So, you know, we'll see. Maybe they can take some rounds. I'm ready to be surprised.
They have. Oh. The other team has 8, so the match shouldn't be starting for at least a couple minutes. I'll be right back.
Firefly has left me. I'm very, very sad.
We are a sorry bunch of losers.
Looks like Sunny has come back, so we should be starting pretty soon.
Nice shot, comrade. Good shooting.
Guess since Firefly's left me, if anyone has questions in the chat, I'll be happy to message or answer rather. Sure, Firefly could have scheduled a better time to, you know, get on that phone sex line, but he chose now. It's okay. Looks like we're waiting on Bowser being a little AFK.
Sorry about that.
It's okay, bro.
B-Man told me that the other team has 8, because I told him to go ahead and get ready and start that match, but looks like we'll be waiting a little bit longer. Maybe we'll actually start at 10 Eastern like they promised.
Yeah, it looks like B-Man's the one who probably has to go do some sixes scrims. I think probably his team is... He's in prime position to take IM this season.
That's not too surprising, B-Man. Do you think he's the best player in gold? I don't know any gold, that many gold players. I'm sure there are other, like, high-skilled players playing on gold teams, you know, off-classing and whatnot, but B-Man's gotta be, if not the best, one of the best in that division.
I mean, honestly, if you were in Platinum, he'd probably be the best player in Platinum, or
that's
at least
true.
One of them. Dude is absolutely insane, and you know other players too. Attila, glad to see that dude back on sniper. He's pretty crazy. Snailboat's like one of those players who's played in IM for like a lot of seasons, and I don't probably isn't too well known, but he is seriously insane.
Yeah, I don't know if he made any big kind of splash in the sixes scene, but he's got really, really excellent DM skills and game sense, and he's been playing the game for a while, so...
Yeah, I mean,
he
is on
heavy.
Yeah, he's playing heavy. He's
pretty
such,
good heavy.
Yeah, he's a crazy heavy. Looks like Bowser's back in, so we should be starting pretty soon. I'm excited.
Yeah,
see
me too.
What these teams can do here on Process.
Yeah, this is a...
It looks like we have started, actually. I didn't hear any plugins. Wait, no. Is this live?
Yeah, no, wait. I think so.
Plugins
yeah,
might be
like...
broken after this at update, but here we go. Fight number one. Looks like that's B-Man trying to control these precious crates here. Both teams kind of just poising back on their own crates.
Pretty
see who's going to be
so
the first
far.
Person to jump into the fray here. As Cruxes go down to Bashes. It's a big pick. Doppel down as well. It's Kessel the Spy. See where this mid-fight goes. Attila with a nice snipe, and then he gets counter-sniped. But it looks like it's going to be...
Oh, it's a crit creep.
Wow.
Looks
hard
like
strings,
Mexican
huge crits. Wow, that was unexpected. I guess I should have paid better attention to who these players were. Crux is the only person alive, freshly respawned. See if he set up any traps anywhere. So there's a trap on this rollout area, but it's been knocked down and deaded. Crux, the lone survivor, and Spy on the point. He's gonna get chased out.
Right?
Yeah, hey, half cap point. It's a great thing. As crits has been popped, No, sorry. Crits has not been popped, JK. But it is building, almost at 100.
Right here they have it. Ooh, the demo decides to take it. Heartstrings looking upper, but he's changed his mind.
Yeah, Catranch putting a lot of pressure on this lobby, taking down Sunny and Fascist, Soldier and Scout down.
Here comes the crits down. From left side. Oh, yes. Some nice frags coming out of Heartstrings. Well, the stabs from the spy helping out there a lot, and looks like this push is stuffed.
I'm surprised they were able to sneak in on that right there. Pretty sneaky, but the heavy got stabbed, and that kind of defeated that push. Good defense from Mexican Cat Ranch. God, I love that name.
Yes, me too. Looks like Cat Ranch is trying to push out to second. They're not committing too many players to this, so I don't know if they'll be able to get it. Scouts.
Yeah, probably
go
a good decision.
Here. Oh, Jagavo, nice DMing there. Takes out Fascist and gets out with his life. With 1 HP.
Yeah, Pepe over on Cat Ranch does have a slight advantage. Probably not enough you really want to push out though, so I take that comment back.
Crips getting a lot of damage on the right side. Looks like they trade heavies. And things will kind of ease up now as both medics are going to get their ubers.
Yeah, Attila and B-Man really close on this rollout trying to get some snipes. They're definitely probably the more aggressive team. They're going to look for any advantage they can use to push out here.
Yeah, and like most last on 5 CPs for Highlander, this is no exception. Very hard to push into 9 players defending it, especially with the crits creep, but looks like 7 years is running a regular Uber. And they're going in right now, Heartstrings taking it in from the left side. Cat Ranch has a pop there, there goes their Uber. Much better Uber for them. They should be able to hold this off pretty nicely.
Yeah, Heartstrings went down. Snailboat pushing up, but he didn't see the heavy sort of hiding in the corner. He gets taken out. See what these teams decide to do, whether they're just gonna sit here or who's gonna make the plays. Oh, big snipe on the Crux, the demo man from Bowser. That could open it
Bowser.
Up. He could. Wow. And the medic.
Too. Really nice stuff. Looks like they're just gonna push in here. No Uber. Oh, medic Uber extends here. Oh,
yeah, I think they're kind of lost. Look, are really disconnected. Kind of just the medic and heavy here in the little side tunnel. Heartstrings goes down, really disconnected from the medic there. That could be the end of that advantage, the huge advantage they had. Although they still have the Uber to fall back on as soon as Heartstrings respawns.
Looks like they're trying to make a play to force that Uber. Billy Bob flanking around, surviving, doing the pyro thing. And I don't know, when are they going to push in? 7 years has this huge Uber advantage, but they wait too long. Mexican Cat Ranch will get it. Looks like they'll take it in now on the left side. Nice placement. Nice place to come in. Solid Uber. They're not getting a whole lot out of this, though.
Billy Bob's gone down. It looks like Heartstrings and his medic have taken the upstairs. Let's see what Ranch is going to do to root them out of this attic, but B-Man's going on a tear. The medic's gone down, Heartstrings down as well. He does get B-Man versus Troubles, but with Pepe at 100%, they should be able to push out here. See if how much they're going to put to defending the second point. It's kind of just Scout and Pyro here. Kyrench does need to move here. Pyro's overextended. He's going to get taken down, but Snailboat gets cleaned up. It's good work from the Scout of Fascist here. Bowser with a nice snipe.
That's a crit screen.
Pepe was on crit screen. My bad for missing that. And the crit screen has been popped. Spies trying to do some work. It's unclear whose point this is going to be.
No.
B-Man takes down the heavy.
They got the high ground, so they'll be able to capture this. But looks like
the demo's still here doing tons of damage.
The control point is being contested.
Blue being pushed back to their last.
They committed a lot to capturing that, but it doesn't really do much good if they can just like kill your guys and retake it really quickly.
Yeah, it just didn't seem like they really fully committed to pushing out. They kind of had a, you know, 1 foot out the door.
Now we'll see. Even Uber's here. Is Pepe still running crit screen?
Yeah, he's still on that crit screen. He hasn't died yet, so
he's looking
it's kind
to
of
use
a...
it.
Yeah, they have to, because...
The snipe.
The red medic only had 99.
Oh, Billy Bob! With the crit pyro shotgun takes out the medic. And 7
Wow, that was so unfortunate. 99%. But, well, with still a soldier in behind. See if he can make a play on that medic. It looks like he's trying for the... Pepe's alone here with the soldier who takes him out with the needles.
Medic's gotta get frags, too.
I'm sure the call came in, soldier behind, and Pepe was like, I got this, boys. Whips out the needles.
Looks like Mexican Cat Ranch pushing out the choke. Crux getting some decent damage out.
And once again, it's kind of just a pyro and scout here. Here comes the heavy with a nice position up on these crates. Demo's here as well, spamming that choke point. See what they can do. I'm sure Pepe's just building up another crit streak.
Yep.
Yep.
This one is harder to use though. Mid is very large and there's a lot of crates blocking vision, so we'll see where they decide to use this. He's got the crits. Attila gets sniped though. They really have to watch out.
Yeah, they're down
Bowser.
Both their pick classes. A lot of is riding on this crits krieg as the advantage is sort of just slipping away. I think not really sure what they were gonna do. Looks like they're sort of staging around and, oh wow, Bowser with another great snipe on a snail boat. Looks like they're just gonna sit back and maybe wait for the red team to push in to them. Which isn't a bad way to use a crits krieg, kinda just bait them into pushing and then just kill everything that's not Ubered.
Bowser overextending here. I really don't agree with that decision. He had a nice position on the crates, and they should know that the enemy still has crits krieg. Here comes B-Man, creating a distraction for the crits, but the crits accomplishes nothing. Getting no frags and the Uber popped out of 7 years, they're gonna push this back.
Yeah, Sunny jumped straight away, killed that medic real quickly. And red team's looking to push in. Shivago's in on the medic! Kessel cleans him up as well. Wow, great plays.
Yeah,
it's almost a full wipe from red team.
Cat Ranch is doing a really good job of spreading when the enemy team is pushing, and I think 7 years is not really sure how to deal with it.
Yeah, it can be really difficult to deal with on process because these flanks are so compartmentalized. I'm not sure I'm saying that right, but you know what I mean. It's like, you know, they're so spread out. It's very easy to, you know, not watch a flank or be down some numbers and have people come in late in the fight and do work. So you have a big bomb from Sunny.
Cat Ranch
a little overextended.
Yeah. Sunny's gonna.
Wow.
Jump. Yeah.
Pepe going down. Great aggression from Heartstrings there to clean up those kills. And they could roll this straight into last with this Uber advantage.
Typhoon's positioning as heavy has been really excellent, and Cat Ranch didn't focus him and he got out a lot of damage, a couple of kills, and kind of just halted whatever aggression that Cat Ranch could put out on that mid. And we'll
reset only couches pull out on this crits krieg. Interesting decision. Let's see what they can do with this.
Looks like
it's coming in the tunnel side, maybe?
B-Man coming in for a jump. Will he get them? Oh, very close rocket. Good try by B-Man. No go, though. Looks like they're really like... adamant about taking a left, but...
Yeah, typically with Crits Krieg, you usually want to see the
left,
demo.
Top left.
Top left, here we go.
Oh, a trap by Crux. Medic drops Uber.
Wow. Great trap
really
from Crux there.
Yep.
And red player's kind of just melting after that. It really sucks when your medic drops like that because so many people are already in position to push and, you know, they just end up getting caught out.
Yep.
Overextended.
Yeah,
so
medic
blue
drops
team.
Pushes, result in
Ranch is going to push out. Red
they
team still doesn't have
the
demo, man. They're probably going
to
lose mid off of this as well. Pepe has his Uber, his crits krieg, sorry. Has his crits krieg. Medic kind of caught out in this choke. No, he's gonna get out. Couch is only at 75. Bowser down.
They have a crits krieg here. I wonder where they're gonna take it. Spy goes for a play, whiffs.
B-Man jumping through, doing a lot of damage here. Creating a lot of space for his team. They might even be able to take this without even popping the crits krieg. A lot of players down, Heartstrings is down. Typhoon picking up another few frags though. Really smart positioning by him.
Okay.
But it might not matter as Pepe. Wow. Bowser with a nice Dorati chop onto Billy Bob. That's gotta be a little embarrassing.
Yeah, Billy Bob laughing in chat. Ooh, Spy goes for a plan, the medic doesn't get it. Looks like 7 years is pushing out.
Yeah, Blue was kind of bleeding a few players there, overextending that lobby. The Pyro on the combo here, on the demo here. Oh! The crit screen gets popped.
What the hell?
B-Man with a massive flank coming in from IT, taking almost completely wiping this red team. Sean Connery, pretty much the only person live. A few spawns come in, but Fascist gets taken down real quick, and B-Man's on the point.
He's gonna get taken out by the heavy. Oh no! He gets the capture as he dies. Good round for B-Man. Good round for Cat Ranch.
Yeah, B-Man went absolutely enormous there.
Nothing surprising about that, though.
That was a crazy round, back and forth. I was not expecting, at least the rumors were right. This is an amazing game, as we do a mid-fight number two. Crux and Heartstrings battling it out here.
B-Man
again, sort of a passive mid.
To watch him. Going in for a cool play soon, so...
As he just jumped in there, brought the medic down to about 40 health. The medic's gonna have to go back and get a health pack, as Snailboat's doing a ton of damage on the point. Oh, but Crux picks up... Fascist picks up Crux, and Magna Defender stabs Snailboat.
Now, the mid actually still isn't over yet. Heartstrings is alive, and looks like Cat Ranch will have to give this up. As they just
got basically fully wiping there, yeah.
I'm gonna go ahead and keep watching B-Man, because, I don't want to spoil it for anyone, but he does something cool. I'll just say that. Here we go.
Oh, the Market Gardener!
Oh, the medic drop! With the Market Gardener. He does not disappoint. B-Man coming through again.
Wow, shout out to B-Man. That was nuts. I saw him flying through, and I'm like, no way. No way this is going to happen. Drops the medic with the Market Gardener. Wow.
Yeah, and actually, Heartstrings and Typhoon are both dead, so this is a good time for Cat Ranch to push in.
Magna Defender, ooh, getting spotted out by Snailboat. Good game sense from him. Red team sort of melting here. They're gonna have to give up second. Doesn't look like Shivago wants to. Oh no, he backs up wisely. Pepe has that crits creep. They're gonna cap the midpoint. Couch is only at 50%. He was on Uber, right? No, both on Crits Creek.
They're both still doing the Crits Creek.
Wow, Sean Connery, the big extinguish. Tons of damage from Heartstrings.
His whole team just died.
The Typhoon, another double, triple kill.
Looks like mid goes to 7 years.
B-Man trying for another Market Garden gets, like, denied mid-air. Steps on a soldier before he can land on the medic. Unfortunate. Expect we'll see a few more Market Garden attempts from him.
Yep, you gotta have fun, right?
Gotta have fun.
Yeah,
as
the
red medic
down.
Did go down.
Yeah, so this is Ranch's turn to push in. It looks like they're gonna do exactly that. Heartstrings caught out. A little bit over aggressive he is, and that seems to be a tendency of
kind Typhoon's
of
still in,
level.
They don't see him behind this rock. Finally gets taken down.
Typhoon is crazy positioning.
Yeah, he's nuts. Like, these are definitely players to watch out for next season.
Yeah, I was just saying that,
Dude, he's pointing with his medic right now. 40 points. Big bomb from Sunny. See what he can do. Gets taken out by Snowboat. Looks like they want to push through this choke here, but Pepe on a little low life gets that sandwich, though.
P-Man's
in behind, though, doing tons of damage. Takes down the engineer.
Oh, Doppel takes out Heartstrings, so no demo man.
Oh my god, two big backstabs.
That should be a quick
That's like
call.
Five down. God, these fights are so scrappy.
B-Man is hungry for another Market Garden kill. Looks like he'll stutter for some capture points. And now we've got, Uber popped. I believe a crits creep from Crux. Not getting a whole lot. Good reflex from Sean Connery, but... Just better positioning, a lot more damage coming out from Cat Ranch, and they should be able to get it.
It's just the Typhoon Heavy alive, and that'll be round number two for Ranch.
Yeah, if you notice on 7 years, Magna Defender, I don't know who he is, but he's definitely not pulling.